know, like, a lot of students here, or some people, they don't really see why we have chapel, and they kind of don't really want to be here a lot of the times. And so, like, a big thing that's been on my heart, and I know a couple of other students' heart, and even the staff and, like, professors, is that, like, everyone comes to an understanding of why we do this. It's really, I guess, a heart posture and understanding, like, why we worship and what is worship. And I guess, just like in a nutshell, worship is really this verb. It's not just like a singing up here. It goes into our daily lives, like how we serve each other, how we talk to each other, how we have this relationship with God and fear Him and respect Him. It's really basically the basis of worship. It's fearing, bowing, and serving God. We say, like, God, my life is yours. I'm serving, I'm living this life in honor of you, because I know that you reign over everything. And so that's just been like this big prayer that, like, we want a lot of the students to understand, because it is this really crucial thing. And, like, once you understand it, it, like, changes your whole world. Because in worship, we come to this understanding of who God really is, and then in that, we understand ourselves better, and, like, why we're here, what we're doing, and life really gains meaning from all of that. And so, like, my prayer today is that a lot of y'all just worship with us, get off your phones, and, like, really pay attention to the message, because, like, it's not another class. It's really this big, important thing that we take with us forever when we die and everything. So this next song is called Promises. It's about the promises of God, and, like, he was really faithful. And something that I always remember is that the one who has called us is faithful. Like, no matter what, he's faithful. And everyone else, when we are faithless, he remains faithful. So y'all just sing with us and really listen to what we have to say and what Josiah's got to say later. God of Abraham, you're the God of covenant, faithful promises. Time and time again, you have proven to do just what you say. The storms may come, and the winds may blow, but you remain steadfast. And when my heart and the speed of the wind will come to rest, great is your faithfulness. us to even understand why we worship, Father. I just thank you for allowing us to have